Around the time of the American Revolution, some North American lepidopterists were paying more attention to butterflies than to tea and taxes. As the redcoats and rebels squared off, the butterfly chasers gathered their own army of specimens, including two new species in the genus Limenitis. One was the White Admiral, a black butterfly with white stripes. The Admiral lives mostly in today's Canada, where it's the official insect emblem of Quebec. And further south in the soon-to-be USA, lepidopterists found a butterfly that was black and blue and brown with yellow-orange spots. The lepidopterist named it the red-spotted purple, which somehow stuck. Today, the purple is New York State's butterfly. Neither insect's name seems totally spot on, but the White Admiral is true to its title in one sense. Like a commando in a combat zone, it uses stealth to survive. Its white stripes break up its butterfly outline, making it harder for predators to target. The red-spotted purple, on the other hand, wants to be seen. Its flamboyant coloration mimics the wing pattern of another poisonous species in its range, fooling predators into thinking it too is too dangerous to eat. For a while, the Admiral and Purple seemed pretty straightforward to the lepidopterists. They were two butterflies with two wing patterns and two approaches to survival, and two almost totally separate territories. But something funky happens near the US-Canada border, where the two insects' ranges overlap. Here, there are butterflies with both colorful spots and white stripes. Kind of like red-spotted purple-white admirals. And sure enough, those butterflies turned out to be the odd-looking offspring of the White Admiral and red-spotted purple. Obviously, when two organisms look very different, it's natural to want to call them different species. But underneath their colors, these two butterflies are surprisingly similar, genetically, anatomically, and romantically. In fact, they mate with each other in the wild just as readily as they mate with their own type. All those factors eventually convinced scientists to bring the two butterflies together in taxonomic union. The two species became one. And it's not just butterflies whose looks can be deceiving. Many other cross-border cousins aren't nearly as different as their various stripes and spots suggest.